will you discover if we come together and do it like we never? I'm just sick and tired. I'm fit to light the fire. Now put this on the wire. The devil is a liar.
See, I got my turtleneck on this morning. So this is like the first really, really cold day. Or I would say semi-cold day, is in the low 30s here in Dallas, Texas. So, but anyway, we got a call. Hey guys, dryer is not coming on. So I suspect it could be a bad breaker, or he says when he flips it on, it automatically trips. So it could be the outlet is grounded or some wires are touching inside that outlet. So let's check it out and see what we can find. Hey, one thing before I let you go, please comment, hit that like button. Let's see if we can get this video to 200 likes. Hey, go ahead and subscribe if you haven't. Thank everybody for watching the videos, commenting, and getting this channel to almost 2K subscribers. All right, let's go in. So let's check that one out. Let me get my bag here. So the one that's popping and it's not, so here's what I probably would suggest real quick. So the one that's popping.
This one works.
Okay, that one works.
Yeah, so I ran a load of washers.
So the one that's popping, okay. So there's a few ways we can do this. So the one that's popping, do you have any of the outlets, you know how you have the red and black button? It's a GFCI.
No,
it's a red. You don't have any, no, nowhere throughout the house, anywhere.
Okay. Oh, bathroom, master bathroom.
So, is it? Do you have power there though?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Here, use this one right here.
Okay, this one where I go for work. So
here, use that one. Plug it in there.
Oh, it's
so, yeah. So the lights light up if it works.
All light up. Or?
Yeah, they all light up. Yeah. Or the two red ones will light up. So we don't know what's going on with this, but let's keep going. So now we're going to investigate the circuit breaker that's not working. Okay, guys. This call has went from a dryer outlet that supposedly wasn't working, and it was working. So I don't know what happened with that, but now we have a breaker that's not resetting, so I have to go up here. I'm in the attic right now, and I'm gonna see which one of these wires do not have power on it. All the other breakers are on, and they have 120, so we need to look for one wire, one piece of Romex that doesn't have power. So I'm gonna use this right here. It's gonna let me know which wire does not have power. Now, when I find out when it doesn't have power, I'm gonna trace it. So let's go. Okay, so that one has no power on it. That one, no power. So let's trace these right here. Trace this one first. So it's gonna be that one. Right, yeah. Okay. So, okay. Okay. When was it? Okay, so it's gonna be that one right there. Okay. Too bad my daughter ran my flashlight's batteries out. Sucks. Bend on that one so I know it's that one.
was that wire right there. Let's see. Okay. Wow, this is going all the way over there. That's interesting. So right over there by the filter. Okay, so I see his. I don't know if that's gonna be it, but I need to trace that wire to see. That's going to a light right there. And so that's going somewhere. Man, look at that, another one. Interesting. That's the one that still has no power on it right there. It's going down the wall right there. Yeah, so this is the one that has no power right now. Okay. So none of those have power. So I wonder if this is where they have it tied in at. And it could be back feeding from right here onto another circuit. Look at what else we found right there. That one, that, so, okay. So, now, what I wanna do, we gotta go back over and trace the other wire out. So got that one. Now let's locate this one right here. So, okay, that's the one we just did. So now, went over there. So then this one right here, they're kind of going the same route. Yeah, they're going the same route. So let's see. So that one goes straight over. So I guarantee you it's going to be one of those that runs over. So yeah, okay, so let's see what we got again. So so that one, right? Yeah, that one. So okay, so okay, so yeah, so it's one of those ones that are running over there also. Let's see, got here. Put a little marker on that, so no, that's the one that's the one that's not live. Okay, so let's keep going here. Yep. So a marker on that, so no. Let's see, kind of lean us right to the same area. That one. Here. Yep, it's leading us right to the same. Bringing us right to the same area. So right over here. Okay. So I need to go put some more batteries in my flashlight so I can see. Okay. Yep. So what they did was they tied that in to the same circuit right there. Gotta find some place to put my feet. Okay. So yeah, so they tied it in right here to this circuit right here. And it's going down there. So it's that one right there that's now power. So it's definitely gonna be. Okay. Can you go open your other attic door? Huh? Can you go open your other attic door that's on this side?
Gotta know how to troubleshoot.
Okay, so this right here looks like it may have went straight to this one right here. Like this may have went straight. So, and we have this one right here. Got this one right here. So see, so this one going to that light right there, then we have this one, so we have, okay, so yeah, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna tie all these circuits back in, the plugs that are in this room, I'm gonna tie all those back in together and have this one circuit right here going right here to this light. That's what I'm gonna do right now. So let's take that one, then I'm gonna go turn the breaker on and see how that works. Okay, and that one, let's see, that one, okay, and then so these two right here, these two, so this one right here is going over to an outlet down there, and this one over here is going to an outlet also. So we're going to tie these back together, and then I have to come back another day during the week to put these in J boxes, put a J box on here and on the other one. So this should fix everything right here. So let's see what we got. Okay, so now I'm gonna go turn the breaker on and it should work. Okay, so now we'll turn the breakers back on, so everything's staying on. We'll check it for 120. Okay, let's go check. Now we're gonna go check the outlets over there. Should be good to go now.
All right, guys, so that was a funny call right there, because when they called me, they said the dryer outlet was not working. So when they plugged the dryer outlet in, they said it wasn't working. But when I got there, it had 240 volts. It had 120 on one leg, 120 on the other leg. So that was about the easiest call. So now, he said, well, I got another breaker then that's tripping. But he thought the breaker for the, he thought the breaker that was tripped, he thought it was for the dryer. But I said, no, that's a single pole breaker. It's not a double pole breaker, so it can't be for the dryer. So come to find out, it was tied down the line to another circuit that was feeding his daughter's bedroom. So, because every time I would try and reset that breaker, it would blow the breaker. And also too, it would blow the breaker right underneath it. So that let me know that it was tied in somewhere down the line with the other circuit. So, but you see in the video, I had to kind of go through the attic and find out which wire was not hot and trace it down and see where they spliced it at. Hey, look, I'm gonna give y'all exclusive access to how to do this stuff efficiently and fast. Please hit that comment button. Let's try and get this video to 500 likes. 500 likes on that little like button down there, and go ahead and subscribe to the channel. We got some more great videos coming. If you found this information necessary for you to learn and grow as an electrician, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. We'll see you next time.